Steve, thanks. Tonight, state water officials have reduced the amount of water they're dumping from Lake Oroville onto that damaged spillway. They've pulled back on the amount of water they're releasing to avoid erosion near power line towers. They're still hopeful, though, they'll be able to avoid using that emergency spillway. Tonight, releases were reduced from 65,000 cubic feet per second to 55,000. Earlier today, helicopters dropped PG&E crews into the area to move power towers on the hillside where water would flow if the emergency spillway is used. And the lake level has to reach 901 feet before water naturally spills over the emergency spillway. At the last reading, it's just about 2 feet away at 898.9 feet. Oroville residents are also watching the situation very closely.
I live along the river. I'm prepared just in case, but I'm not overly concerned, or I wouldn't be up here working.
Officials say residents should not be surprised if they see some water flowing from the emergency spillway into the Feather River. But if it does, it would be the first time in the dam's 48-year history. And here's a close-up look at what that emergency spillway looks like. It is a concrete lip. There are no gates to open. When the lake level reaches 901 feet, water will just spill over it, similar to an overflowing bathtub.